Okay, so this is the Mercedes V6 engine, and the main problem is this. As you can see, there is some kind of something is missing here, and as you can see, this should go here. Okay, what does it mean? It means that because of this lever is missing, it doesn't, the intake manifold doesn't work as supposed, and this causes the rough idling. So the job to replace the intake manifold is removing all these housings for cables, the control unit, and also the fuel rails. Of course, you have to take the pressure out of fuel rail, which is actually quite easy. Here is a little knob. You just attach some kind of hose to this and press this, so it releases the pressure inside the fuel system. But we don't do that right now. When I also have to take out this one, it goes to the inside manifold, and this is a brand new, quite brand new, only a couple of months old, so I will reuse it. That I'm not going to replace that, but that's one part that breaks easily because it gets dirty and doesn't work properly. Okay, the first thing is to remove this control unit. Let's see if I can pull this out. And I have to remove the right one. And as you can see, this is the right one. If you look it from here, from backwards, this is the right one. Don't remove this, remove only the right one. Let's see how this opens. I think that I only have to pull this out. Yeah. If I pull it more. Okay, so I pulled it out completely. And now it's removed almost like this. Yeah. The next thing to do is go to here. And let's see. I have to cut this one, not the wire. Don't cut the wire. Okay. Like this. And then I have to disconnect this one and this one. Okay, the next one. To remove mass air filter and to take this control unit up. Let's see, it comes quite easily. Like this. And then I only move this beside like this. Okay, now we start to see the intake manifold over here, but first we have to remove the mass air filter. Couple of clips here. Now I have used my both hands and disconnected this wire. And then there is this small knob here. Now it comes off easily. Okay. Then I can remove this hose from here. And now this part comes off easily. The next thing to do is to remove this and this bolt here and couple of bolts here, so I can take these wire holders out. So I have to unscrew these That's loosened now. This one also. Like this. Put it here. It might be wise to keep some kind of box to put all the parts so they don't lay around. Okay, this one is loosened. Then I have to change the head so I can unscrew these. This is an easy one. And then there is this one. Okay. And this hose also, I have to take it off like this. Okay. Ooh, oily one. Alrighty, the next thing. I have to remove this, which was keeping the control unit up. I have already loosened the bolt, so this comes off easily. Like this. And what we can see here, another screw which is still tight. And I will take that off in a minute. What I have to do also is to unscrew this one. Like this. I think that this will come off soon. Oh, there's still one here. This is almost, I have to check why it's still holding. But the next thing to do is to take this fuel injector electrical connectors off. So we have to do some engineering. Like this. Hop. Okay, let's do this one. So all the six should come off quite easily. And of course we have to do the same thing to this side also. So just here is one, there is one, and then there is one. Okay, and I think we have to take this out also, because this is holding some cables. Okay. And this one also. Okay, and just pop these out, and they should come off quite easily, like this. Next one, pop. Like this, and then the last one. Tight one. Okay, now it comes off. The next thing I did was to remove this one. It's a sensor down there. Just pull out the white clip and it comes off quite easily. And then we have to remove this one from the intake manifold. Like this. I'm sorry if I have to disconnect it, but I'll do it later if I have to. There's also one sensor down here under this, but I think I have to first remove this fuel rail. Take this off, but I'm not going to do it today. What I did, I did something I already thought I have to do, and started to unbolt these two bolts down there, which holds this. It's an engine lifter. I don't know what is it called, but something like that. Almost there. This is probably fun to watch. I'm just unscrewing some bolts. Okay. Now the engine lifter is off. Yeah, I'm sure that I have to remove this rail, fuel rail. But what I have done, I've taken off all the fuel injectors, unbolted these cable holders, taken off some sensors, and I think I'm ready for tomorrow when I'm going to remove this fuel rail. Well, see you tomorrow.